فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
أبو هريرة رضي الله عنها رضي الله عنه reported that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whosoever performs qiyam during Laylatul Qadr, the night of decree, with faith and being hopeful of Allah's reward, will have his former sins forgiven.
عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. متفق عليه.
متفق عليه means agreed upon by Bukhari and Muslim. It means they both agreed on it. في فضل ليلة القدر. The virtue of Laylatul Qadr we're going to speak about. This issue again, if next week we do have a class, I'm going to speak about this issue of, is Laylatul Qadr at a particular time of the month, in Ramadan? Can we restrict it to the 27th? Can we restrict it? And the aqwal of the ulama regarding this. Ta'ayinu Laylatul Qadr. I'm going to mention that inshallah ta'ala. I think we should make that a session inshallah. I have a little research at home. We could speak about it. But here we just want to go over it quickly. في فضل ليلة القدر, the virtue of ليلة القدر. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told us in this hadith that anyone who stands in ليلة القدر, again إيمانا, we mentioned what does إيمانا mean. Because we spoke من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. What did you say إيمانا was what? Huh? No. A believing in the promise of Allah. صح? It's to believe in the promise of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. مصدقا بوعده. It is to actually believe in the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wahtisaban means what? Seeking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's reward. So if those two are found in you, first of all, you believe Allah's promise, number one. Imanan. Wahtisaban means what? You're seeking reward from Allah. If you do those two, and you stand up in Laylatul Qadr, with that two present, غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِ, your past sins are all forgiven for you. Your past sins are all forgiven for you. Ikhwani and akhawati, my beloved brothers and sisters, Laylatul Qadr azimatun. Laylatul Qadr is a very powerful night. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala made it better and greater min alfi shahr, 1,000 months better than it. So 1,000 months of barakah, amal salih, righteous actions, is equal to that just one night by itself. Are you with me, brothers? That one night that you pray and you get hold of, iman and wahtisaban, is equal to 1,000 months of righteous actions. That's powerful. So we said it's 83, right? 83 years, right? And 4 months. So 83 years and 4 months. From the barakah of Laylatul Qadr is Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He sent down the Quran. As He says, Inna anzalnahu Laylatul Qadr. We sent down it, Laylatul Qadr. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ. What do you really know about لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ? Then Allah says, لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ خَيْرٌ مِنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. It's better than 1,000 months. تَنَزَّلُ الْمَلَائِكَ, the angels, they come down. وَالْرُوحُ, and the ruh, فِيهَا بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِمْ مِنْ كُلِّ أَمْرٍ. Scholars differ upon the ruh here. Is it Jibreel? Is it the Quran or whatnot? سَلَامٌ هِيَ حَتَّى مَطْلَعِ الْفَجْرِ. Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he said when he came to the ayah, تَنَزَّلُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَالْرُوحُ فِيهَا بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِمْ. He says, يَقْثُرُ تَنَزُّلُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ فِي هَذِهِ اللَّيْلَةِ. That night, there are more angels that come down than any other time in the year. Laylatul Qadr, the angels, they come down in greater number in Laylatul Qadr. Because of the barakah that's in that night. And he goes on to say, وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ يَنْزِلُونَ مَعَ تَنَزُّلِ الْبَرَكَةِ وَالرَّحْمَةِ. And the angels are always known, wherever there's blessing and there is mercy present, they always come down for it. كَمَا يَتَنَزَّلُونَ عِنْدَ تِلَاوَةِ الْقُرْآنِ. Just like when the Qur'an is being read, the angels come down. وَيُحِيطُونَ بِحِلَقِ الذِّكْرِ. And they also encompass and they rotate around the circles of knowledge. وَيَضَعُونَ أَجْنِحَتَهُمْ. And they also place their wings. لطالب العلم, the student of knowledge, بصدق تعظيم له. The one who is a true student of knowledge, they place their wings over him, honoring him and respecting him. Based on the hadith of Abi Darda in Muslim, Imam Ahmad, من سلك طريقا يلتمس فيه علما سهل الله له طريقا إلى الجنة وإن الملائكة لا تضع أجنحتها ليطالب العلم رضا بما يصنع رضا بما يصنع. Also, that night, Laylatul Qadr, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He does At-Taqdeer wa At-Tadbeer. It's a night when the Qadr is written. The predestiny of the people has been written. The Qadr is written. And it's been attributed to Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, مِنْ بَابِ إِضَافَةِ الظَّرْفِ إِلَى مَا يَحَوِيهِ. That's what Allah says, فِيهَا يُفْرَقُ كُلُّ أَمْرٍ حَكِيمٍ. It's a night where every little matter is being written. Qatadat ibn Da'amat al-Sadusi, what did he say? Yufraqu fiha amru sana. That yearly, annual, the qadr that's for you is written. I mean, we have tax return every year, right? We do tax return, huh? Walillahil mathalu ala. They write your tax return yearly, how much you've paid, how much is, huh? How much extra you got, and they give you, huh? Inland, the inland revenue, right? They do that. وَفَرَقُوا فِيهَا أَمْرُ السَّنَةِ. The whole year, the matters are being written for you. And Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah, said that the qawl of Qatada is correct. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala chose this night from all of the nights in the year, He chose this night. So it's upon each and every one of us to what? أَنْ يَعْرِفَ قَدْرَهَا. To know the status of this night, and the weight of this night, and what it really means. That night, you need to get hold of it with righteous actions and obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You need to come with a lot of dua, supplication and begging of Allah and hope from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibn Kathir rahimahullah said, وَيُسْتَحَبُّ it is liked الْإِكْتَارُ مِنَ الدُّعَاءِ, to make a lot of supplications. That day, you should make a lot of supplications and a lot of dua. فِي جَمِيعُ الْأَوْقَاتِ وَفِي شَهْرِ رَمَضَانِ أَكْثَرُ وفي العشر الأخير منه وثم في أوتاره أكثر والمستحب أن يكثر من هذا الدعاء اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعفو عني. That's the dua that the person should make a lot, based on the hadith of Aisha, where she said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, أرأيت إن وافقت ليلة القدر. Aisha said, يا رسول الله, if I get cold and ليلة القدر, I get it, what shall I say? The Prophet said to her, تقولين, you will say, اللهم إنك عفو, oh Allah, you are one who forgives, تحب العفو فاعفو عني, forgive me. So the person should make that dua excessive that night, and make that the center of their dua. Naam.
Aisha radiyallahu anha narrated that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to practice i'tikaf in the last 10 nights of Ramadan, and used to say, look for the night of Qadr in the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan. And in another narration, in another wording, search for the night of Qadr in the odd nights of the last 10 days of Ramadan.
عن عائشة رضي الله عنها قالت كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يجاور في العشر الأواخر من رمضان ويقول تحروا ليلة القدر في العشر الأواخر من رمضان وفي رواية في الوتر من العشر الأواخر من رمضان متفق عليه.
This we're talking about في تحري, which is to try to seek Laylatul Qadr. Looking and trying to find Laylatul Qadr. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us to try to look for Laylatul Qadr. Are you with me? في العشر الأواخر, in the last 10 days, من رمضان, in the month of Ramadan. وفي رواية, and another wording, the Prophet specifically said, في الوتر من العشر الأواخر, the odd numbers, 21, 23, 25, 27, and 29. The Prophet said, try to look for it in these odd numbers of the last 10 days, min Ramadan. Muttafaqun alayh. So the word taharru, it means utlubu, try to look for, try to seek. As al-Imam Ibn Athir brings in his kitab, النهاية في غريب الحديث. So the person should try to make sure that they get hold of this night. Ubay ibn Ka'b, he said, Wallahi inni la'a'lamu. Wallahi, by Allah, inni I la'a'lamu, I know ayyu laylatin hi. I know what night it is. Hiya layla, it is a night. Allati amarana Rasulullah, which the Prophet commanded us, biqiyamiha, to stand. Hiya laylatu sab'in wa ishrina. It's on the 27th. He said it's on the 27th. But scholars differed on this issue. They said, this companion swore by Allah. He said, Wallahi, I know it. Are you with me? So they tried to say, how is this matter? How did he know? When the Prophet ﷺ forgot it, because he saw two people arguing. And he tried to solve their issue, and he went out of his mind, alayhi salatu wasalam. The strongest, inshallah ta'ala, that we're going to choose is that Laylatul Qadr is not at a fixed day. And Ubay ibn Ka'b's statement is correct. He was referring to that month of Ramadan for him. It was on the 27th. But Ramadan moves. You with me? And it is not still on one particular day. Does that make sense? And we're going to bring those evidences together. That's the only way to reconcile between each and every one of them. And we'll bring that, inshallah ta'ala, in that session that we're going to. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, خرج النبي ليخبرنا بليلة القدر. عبادة بن صامت, he said that the Prophet came out to tell us about ليلة القدر. فتلاحى رجلان من المسلمين, two of the Muslims started to argue and debate one another. فقال, the Prophet said, خرجت, I came out لأخبركم بليلة القدر. I came out to tell you about ليلة القدر. فتلاحى فلان وفلان, so and so fought each other. فرفعت, it got taken. وعسى أن يكون خيرا لكم, it is possible that it's good for you that it was taken. فالتمسوها, look for it. في التاسعة والسابعة والخامسة, look for it, the 9th, 7th, and the 5th of the last 10 days, 25th, 27th, and 29th. Ibn Kathir rahimahullah took a benefit from the statement of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, which is that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, he said, في استئناسٌ, there's something that can be taken from this, which is what? إن الممارات تقطع الفائدة, arguments, they can disconnect benefits, they can get rid of benefits. Debating and arguments, they destroy benefits. والعلم النافع عن beneficial knowledge. وكما جاء في الحديث, as it has come in the hadith, إن العبد لا يحرم الرزق بذنب يصيبه. A person is prevented from a provision that was written for him because of a sin that he does. And because of this sin that was taking place, what's a greater risk for the ummah to know what Laylatul Qadr was? So debates that don't have benefits, it's not very good. Now, we've got seven more hadiths to go. The pizza's ready. Allahu Akbar. You see that, brothers? I was telling the truth. It's got chicken in there, don't worry. Us black brothers, if you ain't got chicken, it's a problem, right? We don't eat vegetables, stuff like that. Sahi, we want our chicken in there.
Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu reported Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam as saying, our Lord, the Blessed and the Exalted, descends every night to the lowest heaven when one third of the latter part of the night is left, and says, who supplicates me so that I may answer him? Who asks me so that I may give to him? Who asks me forgiveness so that I may forgive him?
This hadith shows ala fadli du'a'i wa su'al, the virtue of asking and supplicating. Wal istighfar, and asking for forgiveness. Akhir al-layl, the last part of the night. Wa anna Allah ta'ala, that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala accepts the du'a of the person at that particular time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends, comes down and says to his creation, who wants, who needs something from me? I will give to them. مَنْ يَسْأَلُنِي, who is going to give to me? فَأُعْطِيَهُ, I can give to him what he wants. مَنْ يَسْتَغْفِرُنِي, who is going to ask me for forgiveness? فَأَغْفِرُ لَهُ, and I can forgive him. Who wants it? Who's asking for it? وَلِذَلْكَ الْإِمَامُ الْقَحْطَانِ in his Nuniyah, he says, وَاللَّهُ يَنْزِلُ كُلَّ آخِرِ لَيْلَةٍ, لسماء الدنيا بلا كتمان ويقول هل من سائل فأجيبه فأنا القريب أجيب من ناداني حاشا الإله بأن تكيف ذاته فالكيف والتمثيل منتفيان. He says, Allah comes down the last third of the night to the سماء الدنيا بلا كتمان, without hiding. ويقول, Allah also says, هل من سائل, is there one who's going to ask me? I can give him what he's asking for. فأنا قريب, I'm close to you. أجيب من ناداني, I will give the one who calls to me what he asks for. حاشا الإله, but even though Allah comes down, he's still above his throne. Allah does come down the last third of the night and he's also above his throne. How does he do it? We don't ask. صح? So this doesn't contradict between الرحمن على العرش استوى and Allah coming down the last third of the night. This is Allah. ولذلك ابن القيم ابن عثيمين رحمه الله, he mentions the sun prostrates to Allah, صح? Every day before it comes out, and he takes permission from Allah. And then he says, oh Allah, shall I come out from where I used to come out? And Allah says, no. Come out from the opposite side, then the qiyamah happens. If before the qiyamah, Allah says, come out from the right place, do your normal routine. He does his normal routine. Every day takes permission from Allah. Are you with me, brothers? Okay? And then, when the day of judgment is about to happen, Allah says, he asks Allah, and Allah says the opposite direction. The question here is when does the sun take permission from Allah? Because when it's day for us, and the sun is out for us, it's night for another place, and the vice versa. So when is the sun taking permission from Allah? When? If we couldn't even understand the sun, how are we going to understand Allah? Yeah? You can't even understand the sun and how it works. Yeah? So this is what we say. If anybody tells you how does Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala come down, you say to him, first of all, tell me how Allah looks and I'll tell you how he comes down. You'll say, I don't know. You'll say, I don't know. Huh? لأن the kayfiyya, the how, is a far'un ani that. The how is a sub-branch of the essence. I have to know your essence to how you come down. If a brother tells me so-and-so is to come downstairs, I don't even need to know how you look like, if you're tall or short. I know you use your legs when you're coming down. Huh? Because I know you're that. The kayf is a... it's from the that. Does that make sense, brothers? But because I don't know Allah's that, I don't know his kayfiyya. And this also teaches us, my beloved brothers, الصابرين والصادقين والقانتين والمنفقين والمستغفرين بالأسحار. That the believers at the last third of the night, they are awake and they are supplicating to Allah. وَبِالْأَسْحَارِهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. At night, the believers are awake and they are supplicating and they are begging from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jabir ibn Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he narrated. This hadith is only found in Sahih Muslim. And Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani in Fath al-Bari, he says that it's found in, that this is found in Sahih Bukhari, but it's incorrect. It's only found in Sahih Muslim. It's not found in Sahih al-Bukhari. And that is that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, in the night there is sa'ah, a time, la yuwafiquha rajulun muslim, a believing man does not get hold of that time. يَسْأَلُ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى, in which he asks Allah, خَيْرًا مِّنْ أَمْرِ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ, in which he asks Allah, in that timing, the good of this world and the hereafter, إِلَّا أَعْطَاهُ اللَّهُ إِيَّهُ, except Allah gives it to you. وَذَلِكَ, and that is كُلَّ لَيْلَةِ, that is every single night. Every single night that opportunity comes. That a believer has the opportunity to ask Allah for something and he will get what he wants. So my beloved brothers and sisters, فَعَلَى الْمُؤْمِنُ الْحَرِيصِ, it is upon every Muslim who's striving, who has got effort and hard work, and is passionate. And every one of us here has a problem in his life and he's got something he wants Allah to forgive him and he wants something for Allah to give you and you want Allah to protect you from something. It's incorrect and it's wrong on your side to not benefit from this time. And that's why you need to come with sincerity. إخلاصنا لله صف القلب من إرادة سواه فاحذر يا فطن. Come with sincerity. You wake up for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala alone. And you do that. And in the last 10 nights of Ramadan, it becomes even more. So we say, اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. We ask you, O Allah, Jannah, and that which would bring us closer to it. And we seek refuge from the hellfire and whatever gets us close to it. Ma'am. How long do we have to the salah? 40 minutes. Okay, Allahu Akbar. We might even finish it before the salah.
Narrated by Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu, that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Allah said, I have prepared for my pious slaves things which have never been seen by an eye, or heard by an ear, or imagined by a human being. If you wish, you can recite this verse from the Holy Quran. No soul knows what is kept hidden for them of joy as a reward for what they used to do.
عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال قال الله عز وجل أعددت لعبادي الصالحين ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر واقرؤوا إن شئتم فلا تعلم نفس ما أخفي لهم من قرة أعين جزاء بما كانوا يعملون.
نعم. So this hadith is في شيء we're going to speak about من صفات الجنة, the characteristics of Jannah and the people of Jannah. May Allah make us from the people of Jannah. That the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, "A'adatu, I've prepared." Allah said, "I prepared for who? Like, for everybody." لعباد يصالحين, I've prepared for my righteous slaves. Who is a righteous slave, my brothers? The one that comes with the awamir and stays away from the nawahi, and comes with also the mustahabbat and stays away from the makruhat. That's what it is. من ثبتت عنده أصل الإيمان وكماله الواجب وكماله المستحب. Salih is a person who has the original essence of the iman, and he also has kamaluhu al-wajib and he has kamaluhu al-mustahab. He's coming with the mustahabbat, sunan, dhikr, adhkar, let alone come with haram and whatnot. What has Allah prepared for them? مَا لَا عَيْنُ الرَّأَتْ, things the eyes have never seen. وَلَا أُذُنُ سَمِعَتْ, and ears have never heard of. وَلَا خَطَرَ عَلَى قَلْبِ بَشَرْ, and it has not come to the heart of any creation. It's something your eyes have never seen. If you've gone to Dubai, huh? Jumeirah Beach. Sah? What's it called? What's it called? The palm tree. It's good? Huh? You go there and you say, like, wow. This is from what the humans have made, yeah? Whatever you see, Jannah is still greater than it. Are you with me? Sometimes when you're dreaming in your sleep and you're in a dream and you're in there and you're in a rich place, you've got a mansion, you've got nice, your kids are hufad, and you know, it's just a big dream, and you wake up and you're in West London. Yeah? You're still on that single bed. It's a problem, right? Whatever you saw in your mind, Jannah is still greater than it. خَطَرَ عَلَى قَلْبِ بَشَرْ. All those dreams that you've had of those powerful manj, Jannah is greater. Are you with me, brothers? Here can be i'tirad can be brought. And this is i'tirad that was brought. Ibn al-Qayyim speaks about in his kitab, Hadi al-Arwah ila bilad al-Afrah, which is, if it's something eyes have never seen, ears have never heard of. Okay. Okay, yeah. Brothers, don't double park on the in the parking spot outside. Don't double park and block other cars. Okay? Especially be careful from the neighbors. So here, pay attention, brothers. If Jannah is things eyes have never seen, ears have never heard of, and has never come to the heart of the people, where was Adam alayhi salam? And is Adam not a human being? مَا لَا عَيْنُ الرَّأَتْ وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ وَلَا خَطَرَ عَلَى قَلْبِ بَشَرْ. Is Adam not from them? Are you in the brothers? Have you guys heard this question before? We've never asked this on this question. I'm not going to answer it. Read the kitab. Hadi al-Arwah ila biladi al-Afrah, written by Ibn al-Qayyim. Go read it. If you can't read it, find somebody who can read it for you. In there. First Fusul, Ibn al-Qayyim mentioned it, speaks about it. Oh, it's a cliffhanger. It's important. And that's what's going to make you learn Arabic if you can't learn Arabic. Another fa'idah. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in this ayah? فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهُمْ مِنْ قُرَّةِ أَعْيُنْ. أَعْيُنْ is what? Also in another ayah Allah says, وَفِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِيهِ الْأَنْفُسِ وَتَلَذُّ الْأَعْيُنِ. أَعْيُنْ. صح؟ The word أَعْيُنْ is تَصْغِير. Are you with me, brothers? According to the scholars of Sarf. Are you there? And since it's Jannah that you're talking about, are you with me, brothers? It should have been used in the usage of the word A'yun is not nice. It's making it smaller. Tasghir means to make something very small. And Jannah is something big and something great. So why A'yun is being used here? This is a fa'idah, nukta, fa'idah, latifa that you can take out of the ayah. The reason is because Jannah, the people who enter it are little. Sah? وَإِن تُطِعْ أَكْثَرَ مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يُضِلُّوكَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ وَقَلِيلٌ مِنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورُ قَلِيلٌ. صح. So the Quran has a hikmah in its usage. So may Allah تبارك وتعالى make us from those who enters Jannah into. What is greater than Jannah? Entering Jannah. What's greater than entering Jannah? Seeing Allah. When the people enter Jannah, the believers, and they're given what they want in Jannah, and they have what they want, and they are told, do you want anything else? And they say, no, Ya Rabbi, what can we ask for? This is it. This is the ultimate goal. But Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he tells them that which is better than it is seeing Him. إِنَّكُمْ سَتَرَوْنَ رَبَّكُمْ. You will all see your Lord. كَمَا تَرَوْنَ هَذَا الْقَمَرَ. Like you see the moon. لَا تُضَامُونَ فِي رُؤْيَتِهِ. Nothing gets between you and it seeing. So clear out there. That's how clear you're going to see Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. فَإِنِ اسْتَطَعْتُمْ أَلَّا تُغْلِبُوا عَلَى صَلَاةِ قَبْلَ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ وَقَبْلَ غُرُوبِهَا فَافْعَلُوا وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ قَبْلَ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ وَقَبْلَ الْغُرُوبِ. And if you're able for it to be not overcome before you, طُلُوعِ الْفَجْرِ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ and غُرُوبِ الشَّمْسِ, then make sure that you're a person who benefits from it. Inshallah ta'ala, the food has come. We're going to stop there. We've got four more hadiths left. Five, right?